Hi, my name is Marla Neufeld. I'm a Florida reproductive attorney and former intended parent. Now, when entering into a surrogacy arrangement, when you are being matched with a surrogate, intended parents want to know whether or not they can have the surrogate exclusively eat organic food during the process. And that question kind of also leads to whether or not you can just generally dictate the surrogate's kind of course of pregnancy and her diet and her activities and things like that. So when an intended parent asks me whether or not the surrogate could eat organic food, you have to take a step back and first consider finding out, does the surrogate just do that naturally? Because any surrogacy matter, you can't force a surrogate to act or eat in certain ways. Obviously, they have to follow guidelines issued by their doctor. But asking somebody to start eating organic food is, in many times, can be like asking somebody to become a vegetarian. Not only is it a dietary preference, but eating or and buying organic food certainly does add to the cost of buying your weekly groceries. So you first want to understand, does the surrogate already eat an organic or mostly organic diet? Now, if she doesn't typically do so, it would be important to have kind of a candid discussion between the intended parent and the surrogate, or at least through the agency if one's involved, before the surrogacy process starts, before the contracts enter into, whether or not, first of all, if the surrogate is open to revising her diet to purchase and eat organic food. And secondly, then you have to think about what will that do to the bottom line of her budget for her groceries. Now, it may add a couple $100 a week to what she would normally buy to purchase herself organic food. So it's very fair and reasonable for the intended parent to take on that expense and to provide for that in the surrogacy contract, that either weekly or monthly, however we make the arrangement, that the intended parents will provide an allowance or a reimbursement for her to now start buying organic food. Now you have to keep in mind that it's easy-ish to eat organic when you're home because you have control over what you cook. But it's not always so easy when you're out at restaurants or traveling, and things that surrogates will be doing as long as they're medically able to do so. So you can't be strict with certain things like this. I mean, you have to understand we're all human, we eat out, we eat in, and there's not always organic food. So, you know, you do have to certainly at the end of the day, trust, you have to have trust in the whole process. You know, trust that your surrogate has had a pregnancy before. She knows how to take care of herself. She's going to follow her doctor's guidelines. So you can certainly have this organic option as a preference and to make your best efforts to do so. But you have to really understand that day to day, nobody can always eat organic. So, but it is an important thing if it's something that an intended parent would like for a surrogate to do, to talk about it at the beginning so it can be properly addressed in the contract. And also so the party's expectations are established in understanding kind of what the diet will be throughout the pregnancy, with the overarching concept that any diet should be adhered to by the restrictions and guidelines provided by the fertility clinic. And once the surrogate is discharged to her OB, that she will follow the dietary guidelines provided to her by the obstetrician. So following restrictions on what she can and cannot eat will ultimately boil down to the medical advice by her doctors. If you have any questions regarding dietary guidelines and what goes into a typical contract or just to contracts in general regarding surrogacy, feel free to call me at 954-761-2929. Thank you very much.